I am so excited to talk to you about SAS macro variables today. And before I dive in, I actually want to explain a little bit why. So when I first started learning the SAS programming language, I was primarily self-taught. I kind of just got by on other people's code, maybe a little help from documentation, and some just guess and check and luck. But then I actually took a SAS macro class, and it was life-changing. It completely changed my approach to how I wrote my SAS code, and I felt like it made me so much more efficient and useful to my colleagues that I was developing code for. So with that little motivation, let's go ahead and get started. What I want to do is show you three main topics about macro variables. So the first will just be, what are macro variables and how can you create them? The second topic will be, how can you manipulate macro variables with macro functions? And then the third topic will be creating macro variables from data using SQL. So with that, let's go ahead and jump right in. Before I dive into code, let's take a look at the table we're going to be using. This is SASHELP.cars. We have one row for a variety of different cars. And the columns we're going to pay attention to in the code will be drivetrain. There's three different values, all, front, and rear. MSRP, manufacturer's suggested retail price, is a number we'll subset on. And one other that we'll analyze will be MPG, miles per gallon, highway. So with those in mind, I'm going to show you this program. This is a simple program where I am looking at a particular value of drivetrain, in this case front, and cars that are under a certain price, MSRP. I'm using front in three different places in the code, in the title and a couple of where statements, and same with that threshold for MSRP. I'll run the program. And you can see that the output creates a nice little bar chart and a proc means report. Now, you probably have had this experience before where you write a program and think, this is great, but actually I'd like to look at it for other values, maybe drivetrain all and a threshold of $40,000. And you could certainly do find and replace or a variety of different manual edits in order to make those changes in your program. But that's prone to error. It can be resource intensive. It just depends. It's a pain to do that kind of maintenance. How could we simplify our program? This is where the macro language shines. So the SAS macro language is about modifying code that rewrites itself. It's so cool. So if you think about what you maybe have done in regular SAS code, things like data steps and proc steps, those are typically reading data, manipulating data values, and creating some sort of output, whether it's a report or a table. Again, those steps are about manipulating data. I want you to think about the SAS macro language as manipulating code. In other words, changing the text within your code dynamically. So, how can we do this? What I'll do is I'll actually copy this program and create a new program to work with. And at the beginning, I'm going to add a statement that's called %let. This is a macro statement. You'll recognize macro statements will always start with a percent sign. After %let, I'm going to name my macro variable, and I'll call it DT for drivetrain. DT is going to store a text string front, and I'll end it with a semicolon. I'll do the same. To create another macro variable, we'll call it max price, and that one will store 30,000. So now that we have these %let statements that have created macro variables DT and max price, I can use those macro variables in the appropriate places to substitute those text strings. So rather than typing front in the title, I'll reference my macro variable with an ampersand. That's another macro trigger, like a percent sign. And then the name of the macro variable, ampersand DT. I'll go ahead and just copy that and paste it in all of the other places where front occurs in the code. Now for 30,000, I'll replace that with ampersand max price. Do a little copy and paste for that as well. And let's try it out. When I run this program, SAS will substitute the macro variable values into the correct places in the code. So notice my title looks perfect. My proc means was generated. And if I take a quick peek at the log, I can see that the where statement has substituted in its place the string front as well as 30,000. Perfect. Now here's the elegance of what we've done here and what the macro language offers. Now if I want to rerun my program with different values, I don't have to make 6 changes, just 2. I can change front to all. Max price, let's change it to 40,000. With those 2 little edits, I rerun my program. You'll see the brand new title, an updated graph, and the log shows the where statement with those strings substituted in the right place. Let's move on to discuss macro functions. And actually, before I get into macro functions, let's talk about regular functions. If I go back to the original SAS program, think about this. What if I want to make that where expression with drivetrain case insensitive? In other words, if the data value of drivetrain is uppercase, lowercase, mixed case, whatever, I still want it to be returned in my graph and in my proc means. So the way we would do that typically is with a function like upcase, so that the data values of drivetrain would be considered upcase in order to evaluate this expression. And then I'd want to make the quoted string upcase as well. This would make for a case insensitive comparison. So that works great. The upcase function in this example is actually converting, if you will, the data values. So as the program executes, it's considering the values of drivetrain as uppercase. Okay, well, how would this translate in our macro program? I'll come over to what we had created earlier, and I would like to make this expression case insensitive. So I'll do the same thing I did before and use the regular upcase function on drivetrain. But now how can I ensure that when all is substituted in those quotes, that it's going to be uppercase, capital A-L-L? I can't use a regular upcase function in this scenario because it's the text of the code that I want to modify, not a data value. So regular upcase isn't going to work. But this is where the beauty of macro functions comes in. Just as there's a regular upcase function, there's also a macro percent upcase function. So let's make this comparison completely case insensitive now. For example, what happens if I define my macro variable dt as just lowercase a-l-l? I want to make sure that when it's substituted into these quotes, that it's in capital letters. The way I can do that is with the macro function percent %upcase. So I'll go ahead and add that around ampersand dt, and I'm actually just gonna copy that where statement from proc sgplot and replace it in proc means here, so they're exactly the same. So think about the difference between these two upcase functions. On the left side of the expression, it's the regular upcase function that's actually converting the data values to uppercase. On the right side of the expression, we're using the macro upcase function. What it's doing is actually taking the value of the macro variable all, and before substituting it into the quotes, making it uppercase text. So it's modifying the text within the program. So let's run the program now and see how it looks. My title doesn't look so great, we'll deal with that. But the bar chart is perfect. And if I look at the log, my where statement is case insensitive, just as we need it. If we want to go ahead and fix the case of the title, lowercase all, you might be familiar with the prop case function that will do capital first letter, lowercase rest of the word. The problem is there isn't a percent prop case macro function. So there isn't always a one-to-one comparison with a regular function and a macro function. However, we do have this awesome little helper function that's called %sysfunc. And what that allows us to do is to borrow regular functions like propCase and use them, but in a macro capacity. So we're actually going to convert the case of the value all into proper case. Let's see how that works. The title looks much better. I'll admit this third section is probably my favorite. So what we're gonna do is actually use procSQL to create our macro variables and assign values directly from the data. Let's take a look at the code once again. And let's say that what I'd like to do here is actually add a reference line in my graph that indicates the overall average miles per gallon for all the cars that we've selected. I could do this with a little procSQL step. So I'm gonna add in procSQL, and I will select the mean of MPG highway. And I need to do this from the table SASHELP.cars. And I will just borrow my where statement so it's exactly the same. And quit. I'll run just the percent let statements in the procSQL step to see that the overall average miles per gallon for those selected cars is 23.5 and a bunch of decimal places. So what I would do at this point, if I were taking the manual approach, would be to take that number, copy it, go back into my program, and paste it in all the necessary places. For example, I'd probably put in a footnote that said average MPG, and then plug in that number. And I'm also going to add in the procSG plot a ref line statement. Once again, use that same number, and this will go on the x-axis. So those two additions, let's go ahead and run the program. And there's the reference line, and we can see the footnote is included in the graph. But think about this from a maintenance perspective. If I go back to the original program and decide, you know what, I'd like to look at rear wheel drive cars, and I want a subset for anything less than $25,000. Well, I've got to update this program in two steps, because first I have to run the SQL step with the new values in order to calculate that overall mean, and then I have to take that number and copy and paste it into all the right places. Again, that makes it really easy to miss a step, to accidentally forget where to put it. And it's just more hands-on. The macro language will write programs that rewrite themselves. So how can we do this with procSQL? procSQL includes a really cool little clause that's called into. And what that allows us to do is take the values that have been returned from the query and load them into macro variables. We start just with into. This is directly after the select clause. And then we put a colon. This is a key symbol that will indicate it's the macro variable name. And I'm going to call this AVGMPG. That's it. So the macro variable AVGMPG will receive the value returned from the query, whatever it may be. So now, rather than hard coding in those values, I can reference the macro variable, both in the footnote, and I'll do the same in the ref line statement. Perfect. All right, I'm gonna change this. Let's go back to front wheel drive. And I'll make the max price 50 this time. And I'll run the program. That SQL code is still producing a simple little report showing us what that number is. And we notice that it is included accurately in the graph as the reference line, as well as the footnote. Now, a couple things that I want to point out here. Notice that's a lot more decimal places than you probably want to see. No problem. Back in the code, in our SQL query, I can simply just add a format option on the select clause. So format equal, I'll do 4.1 to round to a single decimal place. And try this again. and it looks great. Much more efficient without all those decimal places. One other little option I want to mention, just because it can be helpful, is the trimmed option. The into clause doesn't automatically remove leading and trailing spaces. Percent let does, but not into. So if I go back to my program, if there happens to be leading or trailing spaces after, what I can do is immediately after that macro variable name, just add trimmed. That's it. I'll go ahead and run my program. And everything looks great. Now at this point, I'm done with this SQL report. I don't need to see it because really its purpose is to generate the macro variable. I can add on procsql no print, and then that will suppress the report. And all we're left with will be the graph and then our proc means. So obviously, I'm pretty excited about the macro language, and I hope you are too. We've just barely scratched the surface of what you can do, but this should get you started. So going from here, you can feel free to take a look at the links that are down below and maybe see some other resources that could help you. And I hope you'll also take time to maybe enter a comment about how the macro language is going to make your life easier as a SAS programmer. And if you want more tips and tricks like these that I've shared with you, please subscribe to our channel and enjoy other input from other SAS instructors.